Hi there. My name is Aaron Lanchman. I'm a professor of electrical and computer engineering at Georgia Tech, and today I want to introduce pickups. So with an acoustic guitar, you're pretty much hearing the entire guitar radiating at you, but electric guitars present their sound through their pickups. As we've talked about in a previous lecture, the issue of spatial modes gives us some interesting issues in terms of where we put our pickups. Now, a mistake people sometimes make is they just think about where the nodes of these modes are on the open strings. But remember, when you press down on one of the strings and you fret the note to play a different pitch, you're effectively changing the length of the string, so the various nodes move around. So it's overall a very complicated effect. There are piezoelectric pickups. These can be used with acoustic guitars. They're kind of rare in electric guitars, although there are some guitars out there like the Parker guitars that have those that you can mix in with the electromagnetic pickup sound. I've also seen experimental optical pickups, but the vast majority of electric guitar pickups are electromagnetic pickups. There are a jillion variations of these, but they all basically involve magnets with loops of wire. So the strings themselves are not magnetized, but they have to be made of a ferromagnetic material. It's usually steel plated with nickel. And what happens is that the string becomes magnetized when in the presence of the magnetic field from the magnet in the pickup. So you can't have this work by stringing your electric guitar with nylon strings as you might use on a classical guitar. And when the string vibrates, that creates a disturbance in the magnetic field, and that's picked up as a current by the coil of wire. So the pickup isn't actually measuring the position of the string, it's actually measuring the velocity of the string. Now, people use magnets made of all sorts of things. Ceramic magnets are pretty common. These are the same kind of magnets that people use to hold up the artwork that their kids make on their refrigerators. Another kind of magnet is alnico or alnico. I'm not actually sure how to pronounce it. If you know, let me know in the comments below. And there are several different kinds of alnico magnets. All of them have a number associated with them. I haven't done anything resembling a formal study, but just Googling around, it looks like alnico 2, 4, and 5 are pretty common. Although I've also seen people make pickups out of alnico 3 and alnico 8. People will also make guitar pickups with neodymium magnets. Those are the kind of magnets that are in your hard drive. One thing I want to warn you about if you want to experiment with these on your own is that they are extremely strong, and if you get your fingers caught in between a couple of them, you're in for a really bad time. Some pickups, like the so-called lipstick pickups used in Dan Electro guitars, are really nothing more than bar magnets with wire coiled around them. But most use some sort of plastic bobbin and wrap the wire around that. Probably the most common design is to either have a separate pole magnet for each string, or you might have a bar magnet under the pickup, and then you might have pole pieces, one for each string, where the pole pieces are magnetized by that big bar magnet underneath. And sometimes these pole pieces are screws, so you can actually adjust the height of the pole pieces. One potential disadvantage of this kind of strategy where you have a different pole piece for each string is that if you bend the string might kind of go out of the zone of one of the pole pieces. So there's also rails pickups that have basically one long piece. Of course, then a disadvantage of a rail type strategy like that is that you can't adjust the height for individual strings. You can only adjust the height at the endpoints. Notice that other metal used in the pickup, for instance, if there's a metal base plate or some sort of metal shield, can have an effect on all of this. Wax potting is often used to help hold things in the pickup in place so they don't vibrate and rattle around, and this helps with microphonic feedback. So microphonic feedback is where the sound from the speakers will actually rattle the pickup itself, and that's a bad thing. You don't want that. The good kind of feedback is where sound from the speaker or speakers will vibrate the guitar string, and that's a nice kind of feedback. Jimi Hendrix used that kind of effect a lot. But feedback where the speakers rattle the pickup, that's bad. Nobody wants that. Most commonly, the pickup will run perpendicular to the strings, but sometimes, especially near the bridge, the designer will choose to angle the pickup. An additional variable is how close the pickup is to the strings. And you can even go so far as to have the height of the individual pole pieces be different from one another. You might think that you want to get the pickups as close as possible since that will give you the strongest signal, but you don't want to get them so close that the string might actually hit the pickup and then create a nasty buzz. And also, there's a subtle effect where the magnet can actually pull down the guitar string, and that will cause all sorts of weird things to happen. That's an effect called stratitis. All of these design decisions have subtle effects on the way the pickup sees the string, sort of the aperture of the pickup, so to speak. I'm not going to get too much into the details of these sorts of things here. Instead, what we're going to do is we're going to focus on the pickup as an electrical circuit element. And that's what we're going to talk about next time.